In chapter 19, in Surah Maryam, verse 20, it is said, قَالَتْ أَنَّا يَكُونُ لِي غُلَامٌ وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْنِي بَشَرٌ وَلَمْ أَكُ بَغِيًّا.
My name is Hamza, and I will be translating the verses that he recites. She wondered, how can I have a son when no man has ever touched me, nor am I unchaste?
In chapter 19, in Surah Maryam, verse 30, قال إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب وجعلني نبيا.
Jesus declared, I am truly a servant of Allah. He has destined me to be given the scripture and to be a prophet.
In chapter 19, Surah Maryam, verse 34, ذلك عيسى بن مريم قول الحق الذي فيه يمترون.
That is Jesus, son of Mary, and this is a word of truth about which they dispute.
Yeah, go for it. What did you say?
Declaration of faith.
Declaration of faith, you got it. All right, wonderful.
Right? Islam is a symbolless faith. You don't see any cross, you don't see any depiction of Allah or Muhammad, peace be upon him. So Islam is a symbolless faith. We pray to the Creator directly. We don't go through any mediator. We pray to God directly. So for that reason, there is no depiction of any animal, any human, any prophet, not even of God.
Even no depiction of what Allah looks like?
No depiction of Allah, because no one knows how Allah looks like. Okay. Because it says in the Quran that there is none like God. Mm-hmm. So once we make a depiction of God, Allah is not like that.
I see.
Yes.
Okay. I'm Maeve. I'm Maverick.
Okay, good. So welcome. We are having a mosque open house, and I would like to get a feedback from you. What's your experience coming here, meeting with Muslims, and listening to the presentation?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I've lived in this area my whole life, and I've driven past the mosque many times. I have never gone in, but I'm very grateful for the opportunity to visit my neighbors and get to know more about the way that you worship. And I wasn't surprised by the kindness, but incredibly gratified by the sense of community that you have here.
Okay, what did you learn?
It was a really great experience. We've passed here a million times, never came in. I've always wanted to experience, I want to experience as many cultures and religions as possible. And it was a really awesome opportunity. And I also absolutely love the fashion sense.
And what I wanted to say is that I have a chronic illness that doesn't allow me to go too long without food or water. But learning how to, that I can still take part in something like this that allows me to become more reflective upon the human condition by providing for those who wouldn't have it otherwise, it felt very good because it means that I can be included and participate in such such an inspiring practice.
So we can become more thankful to God for the blessings He has given to us.
Yes. Yeah? Yes. No. It's I had never considered fasting as a way to step in the shoes of others, and that I was tearing up because it's wonderful.
So again, thanks for coming. Yeah. We are going to pray inside. You can come and watch. May God guide and bless all of you.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Take care. We want to just get their experience about the mosque open house, the food that we ate, the presentation that you guys heard, and the Muslims that you met. What is your feedback?
Well, first of all, everyone has been so welcome, so warm and welcoming. I saw the notification on the Nextdoor app. I was so excited to come. My kids were excited. Those were my kids who asked all the questions.
Yeah.
Those were mine.
Okay.
It's just such an important thing for us to get to know each other and to demystify each other's culture and lives. And listening to you, and it's focused so much more on what we have in common rather than our differences. And I think there's not enough of that in the world. And there's you think at this point we'd be more educated about each other, but unfortunately the battle continues. So I want to thank you all for welcoming.
Just be close to you.
Assalamu alaikum.
More closer.
My name is Divya Jajish. And this is a wonderful experience for me. Our friend Shahina invited us, and we were blessed to see how our friends, celebrate Ramadan during this fasting time, and as well as we had an opportunity to hear Dr. Sabir's speech, and it's definitely a topic that need to be taken further than this community, and I just want to say thank you to everybody for giving us this opportunity to learn. Me growing up in India did have definitely a lot of opportunity with our friends back in India, how even like from a Hindu community, Christian community, and Muslim communities in Kerala, one of the state that I am from, we have celebrated growing up, we were together. So as Sir has mentioned, definitely I hope our next generations who are coming up in Chicago and all around, they get an opportunity to experience this and take it forward. Thank you.
Well, thanks a lot for coming. What have you experienced?
Same thing. My name is Divya too. And
what, same name?
Same name.
How is that?
Just happens to be like that. I felt very welcome. We know a lot of these rituals from Shahina. She's our very close friend. So she invites us always, all of them, Rahana, all of, we have so many friends from your community, they invite us to all these iftar parties and things like that. So we know a lot about, about Islam.
Let me ask you questions then,
yes.
Right?
No. Yes, but I there is so much intolerance going on now in the world. So it is very important to have events like this too, because we felt so welcome, everybody was so nice, and your speech was so inspiring. I wanted to hear more, to be honest with you. I really wanted to hear more. These kind of events can be organized in churches and temples and things like that, so people know the good side of Islam. Like you said, media propagates so much false information, that needs to be eradicated. We have to live in harmony. Our children need to grow up together, knowing the good side of religion. We all worship one God, just in different names. It's just one God we all worship, and we just need to be treat each other as humans and be accepting. And this was a wonderful event, and I hope we can do this more in churches and temples everywhere. And you are so inspiring. Like, I felt really inspired by your speech.
If you have connection with the temple that you have, you can take my info. I would be so much honored to come also to the temple.
Yes, yes.
So we can build the bridges with our brothers and sisters in the temple.
Yeah, it's very important for,
so
you know.
Let us know and we'll be more than happy.
Yes.
Because as I mentioned, education is the key.
Yes.
To do away with the phobia of anyone and anything.
Yes.
Right?
So and again, the displays you had over there, that was very, you know, educational.
Which ones? Yes.
The one, the displays about Islam and, you know, the five pillars and about jihad, and people have so many exhibits over there.
Oh,
yeah, there are so many misconceptions. I think that would clear a lot. We took pictures so you could, you know, like, I mean, share with people. Because even people we work with from, you know, like fellow Americans, they have so many misconceptions about Islam. Like, I mean, that I thought was a very good thing to have displays like that. That explains everything very simple. And, but like, we can connect to that, you know, that this is what media propagates and what it really is two different things.
Exactly.
Yeah,
that's the exact reason we have those displays. And all of you should have gotten a gift bag.
Yes, yeah. I intend to read the Quran, to be honest with you. Like,
yes,
I just want to understand more. Because, you know, there are, like I said, there are, we also have misconceptions. I wouldn't be, you know. But I would like to know more and read more and understand more.
Once you read the Quran, you can find out four important things quickly. Who the creator is, right? The one God.
Yeah.
Second thing, what is the purpose of life? Purpose of life is to worship the creator and to better the humanity by his guidance. Then Quran also has a comprehensive guidance. How to form just societies based upon justice and peace, a good economic system, good political system, social, matrimonial, family system. Then God also shows in the Quran, lastly, how to go to paradise, right? By worshipping the creator and doing good deeds.
Yes.
So may God guide and bless both of you and your family so we can live in peace and harmony.
Sure. Thank you.
Okay, thank you for coming and enjoy your food. So, assalamu alaikum. I'm here with our wonderful family from India. Which part of India, by the way? Keep it closer
to
you.
Kerala.
Kerala, okay. I'm from Hyderabad, India. All right, very close to Kerala. So, we are having a mosque open house. We want to invite our neighbors, our fellow Americans, you know, our people of humanity as one family. So, we can meet with them, we can build bridges. So, what is your name, brother?
Mohan Ram.
Okay, so what is your experience of coming here, meeting with the Muslims? Is this the first time coming to a masjid?
Yeah.
So what is your experience? How have you felt, three of you?
All good only. Because Kerala mostly populated. So when we were studying, we were not knowing what is the caste, religion and all of my colleagues as well as all students. We were not knowing. We were mingling like anything.
Yeah,
after
just like
50,
neighbors.
Nowadays only some problems are, it seems to be there.
So what message, you know, you are like my father's age, what message that you have? How Muslims and Hindus and people of all the faiths, how we can live as brothers, right, and sisters? What message would you give?
Only because of our nature it comes. From the childhood what we are studying, according to that, we will be behaving with everybody. So I am having a lot of friends.
Muslims and
Muslims,
people of
all,
different faiths.
All types. All types. Even now we are mingling like brothers and no problem so far for me.
Be, right? That's
right.
How it should be.
For
what
me.
Would you say? What message of you know, encouragement? What is your experience coming here?
It's good to know everything. We are coming for the first time in the mosque. We are having lots of friends in India, but in the mosque we are coming for the first time. Mosque.
So much welcome, by the way. And I hope
we call it Iftar Virunnu in Malayalam there.
Oh, okay. That's a new for me. What is your experience, brother? What is your name?
My name is Jajish.
Okay.
It's a very nice experience. And then We are from Kerala and we live in a place where it's mostly dominated by Muslims, and we are very friendly and we celebrate our festivals with them and they celebrate their festival with us. And this is not something new for me. They bring food every time there is a Ramadan. they bring food to my house.
So you had
enjoy the food.
So you had iftar before. Muslims,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
All of you.
So, not something new, but this is the first time I am coming inside
in
a mosque.
In the mosque in the
yeah.
USA.
Yeah. No, not even in India also. I have never gone
inside
a mosque.
I see. I see.
Yeah. Good to see what happens inside, how you pray and your culture.
What is one thing that you learned today in the mosque when I gave the presentation?
I learned a lot of things. Yeah. Mm-hmm. One of the things I learned is you were explaining about the scripts on the side.
The names of God.
Name. That's something to you.
Those are the names of God, by the way.
Yeah.
That He is a loving God, forgiving, merciful, right?
Yeah.
Wants to guide humanity.
Mm-hmm. Good to know. Yeah. And thank you for inviting us to the mosque.
Sure,
great
sure.
experience.
So don't make this the last time. For everyone, we are giving a package that has a mug and also have a copy of the Quran in there. Our humble request is to read it. So you can understand, right? The 2 billion Muslims and 20 million in India, what do we believe? What does God has a plan for us to live in peace and harmony, worshipping the Creator, being good to humanity, right? So yeah, please read it in English, yeah.
What is it?
No, I'm saying that the gift that we gave you, it has a copy of the Quran in there, and it also has a book on the life of Muhammad, peace be upon him. So please read it, understand it, so you can understand who God is, what is the purpose of life, and what guidance.
Only after reading this misunderstanding will go away.
Of course, of course. Not only misunderstanding, now we can know what plan that God has and how we can go to paradise. So I hope and pray may God guide and bless all of you and all of us. Thanks for coming. Enjoy the food.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Take care. Yes. Assalamu alaikum, peace be upon you. My name is Sabil, and next to me is Sister Julie.
Yes.
Correct? And she came here for the mosque open house. So what encouraged you to come here, Julie? The weather was good. You could be anywhere. What made you to come here?
Well, there's an invitation on my church's website and on Facebook. And actually, I missed it, but my mom forwarded it to me.
Ah, thanks,
and,
Mom.
Right? She knew that this is something I'd be interested in. Also, one of my best friends is Muslim.
Okay.
Always wanting to learn more. I was a teacher for 35 years, so
I see.
You know, continuing to keep learning and growing.
No wonder you were answering some of the questions inside.
Mostly that was from my friend about the dates. But.
I see. So what did you learn? I mean, is it you're saying this is the first time you're coming to the mosque?
Yes, my first time at the mosque. One of the things that I learned was your response to a question when they said, one woman asked how you handle Islamophobia. And in my head, I'm thinking, I don't know, maybe education. And right away, you're like, education. Because just like anything, the fear of the unknown can be overwhelming or stigmatizing. And the more you know about something, the less frightening it is. You gave the good example of Chicago.
My own experience too, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's exactly. So coming to the mosque, you met the Muslims first time. You know, there are 500,000 Muslims in the Chicagoland area.
I wasn't aware of that.
Yes. And we were fasting and we broke the fast. You had just delicious dinner, hopefully, right?
Yes, very good. Yes.
Good. So we fasted for 14 hours approximately. And that's one of the pillars of Islam. Have you experienced fasting ever before?
Well, I've been fasting for Ramadan. This is my fourth or fifth year fasting.
Really? Why is that? I mean,
again, to support my friend who's Muslim. But now that I've done it for a few years, I look forward to it every year.
Really?
And I don't wake up in the morning to eat, so I just eat once a day. I feel like it cleanses me, makes me maybe more appreciative of flavors of food and things like that because you've been doing without.
That's exactly what I mentioned, right?
Yes.
Once you're away from it for that many hours, then once you start eating, you can actually feel the blessings.
Yes.
that we often take for granted.
Yes.
Right? And the poor people who are not able to eat and drink, at least we can feel how they are feeling. So help us to reach out more to them.
Yes.
Right?
Absolutely.
You are holding something in your hand. What is that?
Well, I don't know the gentleman's name, but he wrote my name and gave me such a good lesson on the languages. And being a teacher, it seems easy now that it's syllables that you do the sounds, and these are the vowels.
Yeah, Juliet, right?
Yes.
Wonderful. He's a really good calligrapher. And the next thing that you have in your hand is a bag. What is that bag? Oh, yeah, yeah, that too, by the way.
Yes. Be careful of touching it. This is, I think, Fatima's daughter did this.
Yeah.
And this is a bag full of all kinds of goodies. I know that there's a Quran in here and questions about Islam.
Yeah, yeah. So there is a copy of the Quran. Mm-hmm. So this is an English translation, by the way. The actual Quran is in what language?
Arabic.
Arabic. Okay, you're a teacher, you know that. Huh?
I have one next to my bed.
You do? Okay, so
but
it's an extra copy.
I read it as much as I read my Bible.
We do, okay, sure.
Which is not all very often, unfortunately.
So, no, do read that. You know, Quran mentions about who God is. What's the purpose of life, right? How to be a good human, how to help humanity, guidance, how to go to paradise by worshipping God and doing good deeds.
I don't think I recognized as many, was aware of as many similarities as you pointed out. And the readings that the boys did, where they were talking about, you know, Jesus and Mary and the birth of Jesus. I wasn't aware that that was in the Quran. So
you know, you'll be surprised to find out, Julie, that Mary is the only lady mentioned by name in the whole Quran. Surprised, right?
Yes.
Not the mother of Muhammad, peace be upon him, not his wife or daughter or, you know, any other lady, but Mary, who came like 600 years before Muhammad, peace be upon him. She's the only lady. Chapter number 19 is called the chapter of Mary.
Okay.
Right? And Quran says in chapter 3, verse 42, she is the most honored woman of all the women. And Jesus is mentioned more times in the Quran by name than Muhammad, peace be upon him.
Right? But Moses is the most.
Moses is the most, then Abraham, and Jesus is also you know, very much mentioned. So there are a lot of similarities. So once you read it, you know, Quran speaks about that God is one. He's not triune. He's not, you know, multiple partners, sons and daughters, whatnot, but just absolute oneness.
The gentleman who did this pointed out that Jesus, Mary, they were speaking Aramaic before it became Arabic, and that if you look at their way they dress, that's how Muslims dress.
Yeah, yeah, so Jesus, peace be upon him, if he comes to the mosque, you would say, you would imagine that just like any Muslim brother, right? He had a beard. He was wearing nice, modest clothes. An important thing is, if you don't know this even from your Bible, Julie, that Jesus prayed the way that Muslims prayed. You have seen Muslims pray, right? By putting our forehead on the ground.
Yes.
Jesus used to pray that way.
And Mary with her head covered.
Mary had the head covered, right?
So I never picked up on that connection between the two.
Yes, if they walked in here, you know, they would feel at home. Because they used to pray the way that we are praying. Jesus had a beard, he was circumcised, he used to greet his disciples with peace be upon you, right? And he worshipped the one creator.
Oh, somebody gave me this also. They had me all wrapped up, but
yes,
I don't look pretty with it on. But
oh, you would.
So they had me all wrapped up.
You know, modesty is a really important chastity in Islam.
Yes, and I like how they explained that this is not something women are forced into, on one of the signs, and that women are not a lesser caste.
Yes,
I think
yes.
Sometimes there's that misconception.
Yeah, important thing, as you may have seen in the posters, that hijab or the dress of modesty is not a symbol of oppression, subjugation, and whatnot. It's actually a symbol of empowerment, you know, strength, freedom, because we want our Muslim sisters not to be judged and objectified based upon their bodies and whatnot, but to be respected for their blessings, their talents, right? Personality.
Yep.
How religious that they are, helping humanity. So that's what hijab symbolizes.
Phrasing it like that, that's really a nice way of thinking of things, instead of looking at the outside of somebody, but taking a look more at what is in their hearts and what makes them.
Exactly. This is a gift for you. It's a priceless gift, by the way. The other book that you have is about, you know, many questions many people may have about misconceptions about Sharia, jihad, you know, women, Jesus. So the questions are answered here. Then this is a gift from Gain Peace, right, which I'm part of.
Okay.
To you.
I heard you mention that.
Yes.
But I'm not familiar with that.
So I'm the director of Gain Peace. What we do is we provide services to many mosques. Logistics and many of the gifts, so this is up from us.
Oh, well, thank you. This is very generous.
Sure, sure. And also we provide, you know, speaker services, marketing services, so mosque can amplify the message, right? So we can all work together. So that's the main purpose of today's open house.
Yeah, that was a wonderful idea. Yeah.
So again, if you also need, you know, for your church, mm-hmm. some speaker and speaking about commonalities that we have, and God guidance, you can contact us. We'll be more than happy to come and, also...
I hope I would see more people from my church here, but maybe that would be something that they would
you can put it like
be interested in doing, is having you come speak.
Yeah, yeah, so go ahead. You can contact the mosque, by the way, and they have my contact information.
Okay.
And we'll be more than happy, by the way, because at the end of the day, we are all living here, you know, we want to live as brothers and sisters under the one Creator. And by God's mercy, we all want to go to paradise.
Yes.
Right? So what is the pathway of going to paradise? You know, that's what we say, is by doing good deeds and having the right belief.
Yes.
All right. So again, Julie, thanks for coming here. May God guide and bless you and all of us.